What's going on, everybody? Albesky44 here from Gamer Fusion. Coming at you with some pretty cool news. Kind of wanted to talk about the next update for the PlayStation 4. And we finally have a release date for it, October 28th. So that will be coming soon. This is Software Update 2.00. This is coming with the themes, this home screen colors, the USB for music, and of course SharePlay. So it's pretty cool. Oh, and YouTube. So I was on the PlayStation blog post, kind of just wanted to run down through everything they were talking about and what's going to be on this update. Of course, we got the themes, which is really neat. PlayStation 3 had it for a while, and PS Vita got it about like a few weeks ago. So it's going to be cool to finally have some themes on the PlayStation 4. Hopefully, we get some cooler ones in this, though, like actual from like games, because I don't know. That's kind of stupid to me, but I don't know. We'll see. Now, here's the rundown, too, of what is going to be on this update. So, like I said, we got the USB music player. It kind of sucks that we can't put a CD in there to play music, but this is better than nothing, I guess. Like I said, you could change the colors. So, we got gold, blue, red, green, purple, pink, and gray. Also, there's this thing, the players you may know. So, the PlayStation 4, kind of like Facebook, is going to be like, oh, you might know this person. You want to add them as a friend? I mean, I don't know if we really need that, but I mean, it's a cool feature, I guess. Some enhancements for some live broadcasting. So, you can do it from your PlayStation app, the broadcast on the PS4. We got live from PlayStation Now. Some pretty cool features as well. Nothing huge right there, but I mean, if you do a lot of broadcasting, I guess that's cool for you. This one's really cool, the content area and the library. So, I'm gonna read this to you real quick. PS4's content area, which shows the latest games and apps a PS4 owner has used, has been redesigned to help make it easier to quickly find and access content. It now shows 15 of the player's most used apps or games, and additional items will be added to the library. The library on the PS4 has been improved to filter such functions for help organize oriented by the game type. So game, app, TV, video, stuff like that. Or you could do an alphabetical order, recently used, or install date. So now we're not going to have this big-ass line that goes across the screen and waiting to find your app or whatever the case may be. It's going to be the most 15 recently used, and then we're going to have a library where that will put all our other games, and we get to pick the order that that's going to be in. Another thing we're going to have is enhanced voice commands. I mean, if you don't have a PlayStation camera, you don't give a shit about that, but I have a PlayStation camera, don't really use the voice commands too often, but I do every now and then. I'll check those out, though, and see how they are. And the final thing is the library itself. So if you have PlayStation Plus and you get the games off there, you could just have it add to library so that it won't be in your damn screen if you're not going to play it right away and you just want the rights to the game. I think that's awesome. But that's another thing. Down here, we just got the colors real quick. I mean, it's cool. I don't know. Blue's fine, I think, but who the hell knows? Then we also got Update 2 they're talking about here for the app that you get on your phone and the PS Vita and PS Vita TV or PlayStation TV. 3.35 for the PlayStation Vita TV. And what we got there? We're adding 4-player remote play. You got, in addition, live from PlayStation app will be coming to that now too. So we're going to get a new app on our Vitas. And you can watch gameplay streams from PS4 systems. Will be available on the PS Vita and PS Vita TV finally. That's huge. I don't know why they haven't had that on there earlier, but now we can watch broadcast from our Vita or our PS Vita TV or PlayStation TV. I gotta stop saying that. PlayStation TV. And then the PlayStation app is also getting an update too. Now, if you guys don't have this app on your phone, definitely get that because this thing's awesome. But what we got going on here is in the 2.0 app, PlayStation 4 and PS Vita system software, so we're going to get a launch window for that on the app, and it gives a new layout for tablets, and the app's home screen has been redesigned, so that's kind of cool, I guess. If you use the app, it's a great app, I use it all the time, get my messages and stuff on there. But yeah, guys, that's about it. I just kind of wanted to bring this attention, guys, that I can't talk to you, man. Bring this attention to you guys, just kind of show you what's going to be happening this big update, because we got SharePlay, YouTube support, and themes. So That's some big ones. Now, if you guys don't remember what share play was, that's when someone could play the game with you or play that game, even if they don't own it, which is just badass. Finally got YouTube. I've been waiting for YouTube for so long on the PlayStation. It sucks it took so long, but it's cool. And then the themes, of course. So that's about it, guys. Please like this video. Please comment. Please subscribe. Leave me a little message in the comments. Let me know if you guys are excited for this update. What are you most excited for in the update? Just let me know. Let's have a conversation. That's what this is about. Hit me up on Twitter, LBesky44. Like the video. Subscribe. You guys know the drill. As always, though, thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. And, talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching. Peace.